As we looked in the previous lecture about the intricacies of what the Haar wavelet means, now we will look at a very, very practical example of how Haar wavelet actually functions. Now suppose I have a high quality signal, for example 1, 2, suppose 4, 7, 9, 3, anything, okay? Now what will Haar wavelet do? Now how I will keep this high resolution into divided into lower resolutions, just see. Now this signal I will store the sums of, I will use a moving average system of order 2 here. And moving subtractor system. Or moving order. Now what a moving order of order 2. Now what will it do? A moving average. Okay. So now it will do is that it will xn minus x of n, sorry, plus x of n minus 1 divided by 2. It will do something like this. And this subtractor will do x of n minus x of n minus 1 by 2. So what will be the sequence which will be obtained? Just take this, initially 1 comes, no problem. Then, so when this arrow comes at 2, this will become 2 plus 1 by 2. This is x of 0 plus x of minus 1 by 2. So this because as we are moving this initially it was here, then it moved onto here. So it keeps moving. Are you getting? So x of n and x of n minus 1, so initially 1 plus 2, so first value which is x of 1 here will be 2 plus 3 by 2, then it will be 3 because 2 plus 4 by 2, then it will be 11 by 2, then it will be 8, then it will be 12 by 2 which is equal to 6. So this is what will be obtained, because just see, 1 plus 2 by 2 is 3 by 2, 2 plus 4 by 2 is equal to 3, 4 plus 7 by 2 is equal to 11 by 2. In that way this is obtained. And there will be a moving subtractor system. Now what will it do? 2 minus 1 by 2, what is it? 1 by 2. 4 minus 2 by 2, it is 7 minus 4 by 2, 1 and a half, or 3 by 2. 9 minus 7 by 2, it is equal to 1. 3 minus 9 by 2, minus 6 by 2, which is minus 3. So this is the sequence which is obtained by subtraction, and this is the sequence which is obtained by addition. Now please understand what I am trying to do. I will do a decimation by 2. What is a decimation? You know, the word, actually I saw some lectures, so in that only I got this idea that decimation means that in army, in ancient times, the people used, there was some shortage of food and the resources, so people used to kill, the leaders used to kill one out of two. So decimation by two means that we will select only one out of group of two. Decimation by 10 means that only 1 out of 10 soldiers will be remained, else 9 will be killed. So this is a killing process. So now, if I do the decimation by 2 in this case, then what will happen, that I will select this, I will kill this. I will select this, I will kill this. Similarly here, I will select this, I will kill this. I select this, I kill this. So this is decimation by 2, because I am selecting only 1 by 2. Or in other words, I will, I am compressing the signal by 2 factor of 2 on both the sides. So now, after decimation by 2, or what we call downsampling by 2. thus this signal will become 3 by 2, 11 by 2 and 6, while this signal will become 1 by 2, 3 by 2 and minus 3. So now just look at this signal. This signal is approximately like this. It's an average value of this signal, this complete signal. So these are the differences and these are the sums. Now this is what we tell, we are trying to analyze the signal into its approximations and its details. This is what we tell as approximation, because this is averages, and this is what we tell details, because these are the differences. Now when I am analyzed, this is called analysis part of the filter. This analysis side. Similarly, there is a synthesis side of the filter too, in which we will synthesize this complete signal by this approximation and detail. Now the hint behind this is, let this be A and B, okay? Then this signal will be A plus B by 2, and this part will be A minus B by 2. Now if I have this as, let me say, X and Y, then out of X and Y, can't I obtain back A and B? Definitely I can. Simply if I do X plus Y, then I will get A, and X minus Y, I will get B. Simply. So that is what will be the synthesis side of the filter. But for now, just see. And if I represent it in forms of system response, then what will be the system response? The system response will be nothing but 1 plus delta of n minus 1 by 2. Sorry, delta of n plus delta of n by 2, n minus 1 by 2. And here the filter will be delta of n minus delta of n minus 1 by 2. So these are the system responses of what I get. We can also represent it in Z form, which is 1 plus Z inverse by 2. Because 1 delay means 1 Z inverse. And this I represent it as 1 minus Z inverse by 2. So this completes the whole picture. Let me just simply write this everything in terms of simply one block. 1 minus Z inverse by 2, or if I write in terms of system, then it is delta of n minus delta of n minus 1 by 2. This is what is H to n. H details of n. And this part which I am obtaining, I write it completely as delta of n plus delta of n minus 1. Okay. So this is what I am telling. This was H difference and this is H approximation. Okay. So when this system passes through this both system and then it is down sampled, then this is what will be the analysis side of the Haar filter. Haar MRA, okay? Haar MRA. So in the next lecture we will study how we will synthesize the synthesis, how we will do the synthesis part, okay? So now this was the previous one was the analysis part. Now let us look at the synthesis part. Synthesis. Now what will happen in the synthesis part? Just think of it. In synthesis part, we have these approximations and we have these details. We have to retain back this signal. Remember now, in the previous time I told you that these all things are A plus B by 2, and this signal was A minus B by 2. Just look at it also. 1 plus 2 by 2 is 3 by 2 and 1, okay, sorry, 2 plus 1 by 2 which is 3 by 2 and this is 2 minus 1 by 2, this is 1 by 2. Okay, so sorry, it was B minus A by 2. Because A and B, when the filter happens, then it becomes like in a moving average system, it is x of n minus 1 by 2. So it is B minus A by 2 and B plus A by 2. A plus B, A minus B doesn't differ, but this is how it happened. So 2, B plus A by 2 and B minus A by 2, so this was something like this. Now if I have to obtain the original signal, I have this signal and this signal. Just tell me how should I approach. First, what we do is we do the counter process of the decimation. What is decimation? Decimation means out of two we select one. So if this is the complete signal, so out of this complete signal, what will we do is that we select only this. One out of two. So this is what is decimation. We also write it as x of 2n. Because we are compressing the signal by a factor of 2. So x of 0 will be selected, x of 1 will not be selected in that sense. Okay. So it was sort of x of 2n. Decimation is like compression. And so there is also called upsampling or zero interpolation. Upsampling or zero interpolation of order 2, or here we can write downsampling by 2. Now what we will do is that we have the signal, we will insert zeros in middle. So what will I do is that I will insert zeros. Okay, so this is what I will do. So this is nothing but upsampling, or what we call zero interpolation. We add zeros in the middle. So this is nothing but x of n by 2 similarity or expansion of the signal. This is not right form of interpolation, but just think of it like this. So now after upsampling operation, just tell me how the signal will look. The signal will look something like 3 by 2 comma 0, 11 by 2 comma 0 and 6 comma 0. And here this, how will the signal look? The signal here will look something like 1 by 2 comma 0, 3 by 2 comma 0 and minus 3 comma 0. Isn't it so? Now you remember this, what this represents. This is A plus, or let me other way write, B plus A by 2. This is B minus A by 2. Similarly, this is the sum of both. If this is C and D, then this signal is nothing but B plus C by 2, and this is B minus C by 2. Isn't it so? These all are going. Now I have to obtain back this whole signal. Just think. What should I? What I will do is that I will just simply do the reverse process. I will see. What will I do? If I add both of them, then what will happen? 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2. What am I getting? B? If I add both the signals, what do I get? So let this sequence be x1 and and this equal to x2. And let this samples be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, this indexes. So whenever I add these both signals, I get all the odd sequences. So let me add them. So if I add them, what am I getting? Just let me just write it here. Okay. The addition of both I'm writing. This will be 2, 0. Then this 11 plus 3, 14, 7. 0, 3. And if I take the differences of both of them, this minus this, what am I getting? Just see. 1, 0. One, zero, four, zero, nine. So I am getting here in this case, I am getting this 2, this 7, this 3, and in this case, I am getting this 1, this 4, and this 9. Now if I have to merge, what will I have to do? I will have to shift this signal. This is a different signal. If I shift this different signal, this is some signal, by just 1, or I introduce a delay of Z inverse, okay, and add both of them, okay. So if I just see, so then if I just introduce a delay and add both of them, I will get nothing but 1, 2, 4, 7, 9, 3, simply because if I introduce a delay, there will be 0, 2, 0, 7, 0, 3. Here there is 1, 0, and now if I add them, 0 plus 1, 1, 2 plus 0, 2. Because 0 is introduced because there is a delay of, okay. 7 plus 0, 7. 9, similarly, we get the original sequence. So, to just summarize what we did, is that after upsampling the signal, we took the sum of both. Delayed it by 1. We took the difference of both and what we did then was added them to get the final output. Okay. So this is how we get this synthesis part or original synthesizing the original signal. We can simplify this whole thing rather than just adding this both signal, which is intuitive for understanding. There is another method of looking at this the same stuff by simplification of this process, which we will see in the next section. So now let us try to find how it interprets in the system. So like, if this one is x1 and then this one is x2n, at this point, if you look at this signal, then it is x1n plus x2n by 2. And when I delay it by z inverse, then it become, or not by 2, sorry, just this x1 of n plus x2 of n. And whenever I delay of both of them, then it will become x1 of n minus 1. Plus x2 of n minus 1 at this point, because there is a delay introduced. Here the signal is x1 of n minus x2 of n, and now if I am adding both of them, so what will remain? here I can write it as x, the sum of both, and if I keep the terms of x1 x1 together, this signal will be x1 of n plus x1 of n minus 1 plus x2 of n minus 1 minus x2 of n, in some sense. Okay, or I can, what can I say is that the signal here, if I keep something like this, one plus z inverse by bus 1 plus z inverse or 1 plus z or the just sum, because or delta of n plus delta of n minus 1, and here if I keep the system as minus delta of n or delta of n minus delta of n minus 1, and here if I keep the difference, then I will get back the original system. So this, by doing this stuff, I complete what we call it as synthesis point. You know, how did I simplify x1n and x2n? I first wrote the how intuitively I was getting the stuff. Then I represented this output, the sum of the output, in terms of just combining which were x1n and combining those which were x2n, and then trying to find an expression out of it. So by this we complete the synthesis part of R. So now let us just recap how the complete picture of R synthesis and analysis part was. I started with a signal, original signal, x1. And then I tried to divide it in the approximation and detail in the analysis part of the signal. Or if I write in terms of Z transform, it is 1 plus Z inverse by 2, and this is 1 minus Z inverse by 2. So, and then I downsample it. This completes my, what we tell, analysis part. Then I followed this process by a synthesis part, okay? Or synthesizing. I transferred it by an antenna and received it by an antenna and just did the process now. Okay? This is antenna. Now I upsampled it, and after upsampling it by 2, I did this process, 1 plus Z inverse and 1 minus Z inverse, and I subtract the two or a factor of minus, and this comes out in this way. So in this way I reconstructed the original signal, this X of energy. So this is how the Haar wavelet works, Haar form of multi-resolution analysis. We can, as we divided into two, we could have divided into multiple stages. For example, this details will remain the same, but this approximation gets divided into further two. Then at the receiver end, this two again combines into one. But what is the use of all this? Now suppose you are watching a television. Okay, in television, you are getting a very good, you are transmitting a very high quality HD video. Now, because of some weather problem, okay, you are not able to receive the good signal. Now, how you transmit is by the same method, the Haar, this process. They are digging into approximation and detail, multiple levels. This is approximation, and this is details. My bandwidth get reduced. So, because of this thunderstorm, my bandwidth is reduced. I can't transmit now this both of the signal. Now what will I do is that I will only transmit this approximation, leave the details. So if I just get the approximation signal, then this approximation will serve as not an HD but DIVX quality or some okay quality, okay quality of television will come. So in that sense, when the bandwidth is low, I am able to use this Harmony resolution analysis to get a lower resolution and get it work. So in that sense, the whole signal won't be distorted because of it. You will get some amount of good quality signal. So that is the main use of the Harmony resolution analysis, that we don't lose almost every information because of the bandwidth issue. So